So we're here in PowerPoint, and I want to talk about how to create a grayscale very quickly with a PowerPoint program. My name is Colleen Reynolds. I'm an art instructor with Western Nevada College, and I'm teaching the Visual Arts Foundation course. So we want to begin by opening our PowerPoint application. I'm on a Mac, so I'm working with Microsoft PowerPoint for Mac. And if you're on a PC, it will be similar. There might be a few changes in where the menu locations are. But to start with, I want to open up the application. I get this screen and I want to create a new presentation. And I want to go to my design tab. First thing I want to do is change the size of my paper so that it is going to print out just right on my printer. So my paper is 11 inches wide and 8.5 inches tall. And I do want this to present in a landscape format so that it'll print that way as well. So I want to say OK. I'm going to scale up. It's talking about those placeholder boxes, which I'm going to delete right now. So I want to click on the edge of the box in order to delete the box. So now what I want to do is create a grayscale chart that's accurate. So again, I'm going to come to my, so this is my menu bar up here. This is my submenu bar. And each time I click one of these submenus, I get a different set of quick tools that I want to work with. I'm going to go to the Home tab because I want to draw some basic shapes. So if you come over here, you can insert a picture, you can do some basic shapes, you can do a text box. So I'm just going to do some basic shapes. So I'm going to click the little down arrow, and I want a rectangle that's a square. So in order to make sure that the height and the width are the same on a square, I want to hold down the shift key while I create my box. And I want this to be about an inch square. So you'll note I have my ruler on. So I want to get this to be about an inch square. So if I set that up at 0, it's a little bit large right now because I want to be able to make 9 grayscale boxes across there. And I also want to make sure that I held the shift key down while I drew the box in order to make sure it stayed the same height and width as I drew it. So now I want to format this box so that it's grayscale instead of blue. So my first box, I want it to be white or no fill. So I'm going to make sure I have the box selected. I'm going to come over here. This is the shape outline color, and I want to give it a black outline. But the shape fill, so the shape fill, or color of the fill, now instead of blue, I want that to be white. So if I click anywhere on the document, then that deselects that object. So now I have my first grayscale, which is white. So in order to make sure that all my boxes are the same, instead of redrawing them, I'm going to just copy this one. So your best way, do the best kind of copying you want. If you right click, you can copy that way after the short menu comes up. Or if you hit on a Mac, Control C, and then Control V, you can also copy and paste. And then you see I've got two boxes of equal height and width. And I want to do 9 of these boxes because I want to go a grayscale 1 to 9. So first off, I'm going to do the boxes. So now I can just hit Control V each time, and that makes sure I'm copying the same box, the same size. And I want to make sure they're lined up. The little red arrows will come up to show me when I'm nice and lined up. How many have I got? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 2 more. 8, 9. So there I've created the 9 grayscale chart. So now I want to make sure that I have an even gradation as I go from 1 to 9. So I'm going to select 9, and I know that one has to be black. So I'm going to go to black there. And now I want to find the fifth, or the middle value. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So in this one, I want it to be middle gray. So if I pull down this drop-down menu, you can see I have white, then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 values of gray. I want to only have 5. So I've got to find the middle gray, which I'm going to call this gray right here. Now to this box, I'm going to go darker than that. So I'm going to start with this gray, slightly darker. Oops, that's the same color. So we'll go one shade down, and then one more shade down, and then one more shade down from that. Then we'll go up from there. So select the box. Then I'm going to select the, that was middle gray, so one down. Then one down from that. And then one down from that. So there I have a nice evenly graduated grayscale box. Now I also want you to put the number coding on it. So I'm going to take a text box and I'm going to put 1, and I'm going to format that text box so that it's centered and then above the box. Now I'm going to copy and paste that as well. I'm going to move it over there and align it up. And you'll note that the newer versions of PowerPoint, you want to find the move tool. You keep moving your cursor around till you find it. See, that lines it up. It tells me it's in the center. That's what I want to do. But I want to change this to a 2. So in this class, the values, the lowest, the highest value is 1. The lowest value is 9. So once again, I'm going to copy paste that. Click off it. Use the destination. Okay. So it's just asking me if I want to use the same font. So it's telling me if it's lined up or not. Then I'm going to change that to a 3. On the box, change the number to a 9. So now they're aligned centered wise, but not necessarily to each other. So I'm going to select all the numbers where I've missed them. I'm going to select them. I'm holding down the either the command on a Mac or the shift key, and I'm selecting all of those objects. And now I'm going to come to my arrange. Pull the little arrow down. I'm going to align them so all the tops are equal. So now they're centered on their boxes. And I have a value scale from 1 to 9. And now I'm going to select everything. And I'm going to go back to the Arrange tab. And I'm going to group all those objects. So now when I move, it moves the whole thing. And perhaps I want to make several of these and print out it on one piece of paper. So I'm going to now copy the whole grouped object and move it down so I can print several copies of this all at once. Another thing we're going to want to do is I'm going to ungroup this object for a moment, is we want to set up a value scale or a determination tool. I'm going to go back to my shapes and I'm going to find a circle. And I'm going to put a circle. Oops. So I want to hold the shift key down again so that I create a circle. So I grab my circle tool so that I create a circle and not an ellipse. And I want to put a little circle in the center of that square. So I'm going to align them to center, and I'm going to align to middle. Now I want to put that as a white dot. This is just so I know where to hole punch. I didn't have the grab tool, so you want to make sure you have the moving tool. And I'm going to try to get it to center that way. Paste another one. Is it coming up? So I want to center it. Paste another one. Center it. Try to center it with this one, and on the 5. Go, and then the last one over there. So this one is going to be my value scale tool in order to determine value of color. Just going to make sure I have all these lined up. So I'm selecting one, holding down the shift key, selecting the next object. And now I'm going to align that. And let's center them all. Whoops, didn't want to center. I want to align to middle. There were some that were slightly off. Okay, and then once again, I want to group that so I don't move things around. Group that as an object. So that's the idea behind creating a value scale in PowerPoint so that it's accurate. Move this one down just a little bit. You can also distribute these evenly by selecting them all. And come back to the Arrange tab. You can align and distribute vertically so that the spacing in between each of those objects is the same. Okay, that's all I wanted to show you. It shouldn't take you very long to do that part of your exercise on your assignment when we're working with color as value. This will be a handy little tool for you. Please don't hesitate to ask if you have any questions. I'll be happy to address them.